on that.
Polish look over there, okay? And also that's towards the north, towards Corozal, Orange Wall. Last two hills you're seeing, standing last will be right in the middle, in the valley. Then the last hill you're seeing on the extreme left, as you know, there's the build fire here, you build fire there.
Yeah.
You can, you know, you can know communication right, yeah?
Yeah. Ah, who's Sheila?
The first two ladies who came up here, one named Sheila and this one is Ree. So I named it after their name. You know, the view, you know. So they were, the archers are just working in here, they're still registering and labeling, you know. Not finished yet. It'll take many months, huh?
We'll send you photos.
Yeah.
Maybe that'll help.
Have enough. I'm always taking pictures like every now and then. Not that far, you know, but you know, it's the same spot where they are, you know?
Yeah. Well, that's important.
Right. I suppose this is a hole.
Yeah.
It could be a sinkhole or a cave. So, what I did, I see the formation of these rocks, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
And I see I can come in and I, you know, repel back way like a frog. You know, but I say, I just want to go, I like caving. So I say, I gotta go see what's down there.
Yeah.
I must find a cave and I make it history. There, it's cold.
You
don't? So I actually came down, and you see where my foot is right down here?
Mm-hmm.
That's the spot where I stooped down, and when I plunged down with my headlamp, I see some broken shards, a fracture. And I say, gosh, this is a cave.
Yeah.
Then I can land down, I can land, because then I see I can come down, easy, without nothing.
Yeah.
I'm on my own. So when I land down, I see the formation of steps, more patches. I said,
oh my God,
this is a cave. Then I went down, it just blew my mind away.
Wow. Yeah.
And then it shocked me too.
Yeah.
Because I didn't expect that or whatever, but it gave me a shock, when I reach in the center of the cave, where I really center of the cave, my hair come like here.
I bet. Stand right up.
Come on, Bols, be a man, you know, you're with the Mayas. Then I ask, I ask the Mayas, well, I'm between you guys, but I'm a Maya too, so thanks for for the treasure. And I scream like I'm drunk, you know, like really drunk. And I say, I make myself a hero, you know. So
scream from joy, and why not?
I make it a history,
absolutely,
you know.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Anyway, I'm like crazy. I came out and I check everything, and I say, the same time, I take all the rocks with my water, then I put the gate, you know, I can secure it, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's still not secure like my body, see, because then they have tried broken,
Okay.
I'm at the bottom already.
Okay.
Next
poison. Come down.
Just go slow. Take your time.
Yeah. Get this one. Mm-hmm.
Have a look over your shoulder at me, babe.
Hello.
Okay.
Should we look at it?
But look at the lip on the pot, on the shard there.
Wow. Yeah, that's a cooking pot.
Amazing, yeah.
On top of the stalagmite.
Oh, I see that.
Oh.
Which is actually there. It's not me that put it there. And there, a piece of it drop off some from the height, and one of our guests picked it up right there. It's not me that picked it up.
Mm.
Yeah, so you can see more things appearing.
Mm-hmm.
Things are going and things are appearing, you know.
Wow.
And then the name of the cave? Bols,
machine
cave. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, guys.
There's more shards
right
there.
These formations. Okay, here we are. You see this rim here? Mm-hmm. It is not me that put it there, it's by the Mayas.
Really?
Yeah, so, but I believe it has a chamber to the back there, up there.
Oh.
Where the ancient Mayas used to, I mean, eat for food sources. What they do, they chip the tip and suck the flesh out. You know?
Really?
Yep. Then, what they do next, when they get white like this, you can burn it and see the water on it, and they go powder like cooking, which you call white lime, where they cook their maize, okay?
Okay.
Right. Then we have two pots, which is 18 inches in diameter. They are cooking pots, okay? Yeah, you see the difference between a cooking pot and a jar, okay? Then this is the bottom of a pot. And then we have five oval prints here. We have a piece of a knife, or a dagger, if you want to call it. Then we have 38 polychrome pieces. We have some at the bottom there and some up there. Look at the pieces, you know. And also, before you ask me a question, Mayas believe that they broke anything that the owner used or whatever, so that nobody used beside the owner, and they believe they use it after life. Then we have a complete bubble there, here, which broke into like six pieces. Then you can see evidence from the sea. Seashell is still there.
Oh, in the back?
Yeah.
Yeah.
There,
huh?
Yeah.
So you can really tell that the cave was underneath the sea. And it's the sea that's formed the cave. It's not been occupied or made by the Mayas. Once it's been broken, and it's been destroyed by termites, okay? Mm-hmm. Then we have a pulley, three-quarter of a ball, another three-quarter of a ball. Then we have a rock there, which is like, not for the Mayas, okay? Then we also have a beetle, which is painted black in color, okay? Mm-hmm. Then we have more of a prints, we have five more of a prints here. Then we also have a bottom of a pot, where the ancient Maya used to, like when they serve you, it rattles, you know?
That's oh, interesting.
There's a clear marble in there. Right? Ah. Yeah, you know, hold it.
Oh, I'm too sweaty.
Yeah.
I'll leave marks. No, right, thank you.
Yeah. I know. We tell anybody that when you're perspiring, or you touch anything, you cannot eat it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
Okay, this is for group E. Mm-hmm. Then we will now go down into the cave.
Okay.
Now the cave open, okay? Then we have nine rims from water jar. You see the difference between a cooking pot and a water jar?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's a three-quarter of a water jar. It's like a funnel, right? Then we have tools from the Paleo Mayas, or the Indians, you know, which is dated very old, 10,000 BC, according to archaeologists, okay?
Oh, look way up there, Barb.
Right.
Oh, yeah. My goodness.
Then we have a monkey piece, eh?
Yeah. Oh, you do! Oh my goodness!
Yep.
Look at that.
Then we have a three-quarter of a plate there. Then we also have a piece of a incense burning dish. Eh? I still have a little bit of the copal stuff in there.
Wow!
And then it's decorated like the paper or the cottonwood. Yeah. You know, the outside. And it's secretary for the Mayans, okay?
Now, what are the two little round ones here? That one there
that's
and
a petal.
One.
That's a petal, like for like metal.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but it's been broken. Uh-huh. This one is a roller, like for jug wax in between like cracks. Okay?
Oh, okay.
Okay. Then this is a natural formation rock, I mean limestone. Then this is a conch shell design like a butterfly for the Mayas. Eh? Then we also have wall plinth, spear, double spear.
Uh-huh.
Then we have a spear, then we have sacrificial knife, guys, okay? Those are knife and the Mayas, sacrificial ones, okay? Then we have more spear, then we have a pestle from the sea, then we have a mortar pit, and a pestle too.
Oh, right? The tiny one, yeah.
The way you want to call it. Then we have a quart of a water jar, one oil plant. This look like a shape of, look like a slab of soap, okay?
Mm-hmm.
That's to shave the pot and over the pot, okay?
Oh, okay.
Right? Then there's a handle of a knife. That stone is from where they shape the pot as well.
Mm-hmm.
And that's an obsidian shape like a scorpion, okay?
Oh, wow.
Right. Then that's a little petal. Sorry, move it. Used for metal as well. It still have that little red coloring, but it's all been destroyed by water, where it drip from stalactites.
The red back, okay? Was astounding. Mm-hmm.
And this is not it, because then archaeologists come, they'll excavate here. Oh man, the Maya used to build fire right there. Right there.
Oh yeah.
It's where the ashes.
Okay.
And then when they burn the fire here, and make fire.
Yeah.
It look like they has entered the nut and moved to the south.
Oh.
You see how much smoke, like, you know, the wall in here, the nation, the same
pattern.
Wow. It's all smoke.
Well, yeah, it was, that's what we figured. Following the smoke trail would be a way to follow the caves, right?
Right. Mm-hmm. Okay, can I now? We have group D in front of me here. Every group is used for bloodletting, okay?
Mm-hmm. Okay.
The plate. Then we have an intact part, which is unusual. You cannot find this, okay? Intact means complete.
That's
okay?
Complete.
Right. Then we have a piece of a pulley here. Bottom of a pot, which is dated, which is post-classic means after Christ, but 350 AD, according to archaeologists, not born. Okay, then the handle of a pot. Then we have a shape like a something of a clear.
Oh, yeah, like a frog, maybe.
It's a frog.
Or...
It's a frog. But then another piece is gone. Somebody eats it. Like, you might have believe in, you know, broke everything. Then here, this is to shape the hole.
Oh, wow.
The pot, okay? Then this is a stand of a pot, a stand of a pot, a handle of a pot, a headdress, eh? Then we have a wedge, we have another type of pulley, more, we have eccentric, we have flints, more eccentric, more obsidian, arrowhead, spare piece, spare head, obsidian, then we have a weighing stone or a balance, okay? Then we have a pulley, a wood beater, and a sling, and also, the Mayas used to read their luck with it. How, I do not know. And they used to do weaving, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, strings.
Oh, that makes sense, yeah.
Then a piece of a dish, half of a dish, half of a kettle where the ancient Maya used to boil their tea or herb.
Mm-hmm.
But the other pieces, we don't know where they are. Then we have a piece of ball, piece of, like, tights. Then we have more flints, more piece of obsidian, or flint, a big pestle. A jaguar tooth and a tapir tooth.
Wow.
And more petunias, okay? Then we have more obsidian and a piece of crystal. Okay?
Wow.
A ruler again, which has been used and, you know, and erect. A pulley.
Mm-hmm.
A head of a fish, which is not from the Mayas, is where water drips from stalactites. It's a head of a fish, okay? Then we also have necklaces, a drill spin, a bottom, an Asian bead, which those beads are dated 950 BC also. And a petal like a sun, you know?
Wow.
Then a clay tool again. Then we have more chisel and wedges, okay, or hatchets. Then we also have a conch shell, which is designed like a skull, but we cannot make it out today, okay, so broken, right? Then we have a three-quarter of a plate, okay, guys? Then come here to me.
Yeah.
You want a bright flash? Who got a bright flash? Can I buy a flash again? Okay, look here, you want a flash with a flash? You'll see a Maya woman with a big nose and her mouth, her eye, her ear.
Oh, right there.
Where her head.
Oh, my word.
And her ear is slashed down. And her hand is full, adoring something, you know?
Uh-huh. That's better. Yeah. That's amazing.
Yeah. Anything you see like that, the rich. Anytime you see something like that, you can tell that the cave is rich. Any cave that's rich must have a grip on it. Something like that.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe that this cave has been ruled by a woman.
Okay, makes
because
sense.
Because then I will give you more information when I discover at the entrance of the tree. Okay, we hope this.
Thank you, sir. I love you. Yeah.
Watch out, this part of this. What do you say? Oh my gosh, look at that.
Don't worry, you have just friends on everybody to worry them out.
Yeah, don't worry, mom, it's good.
Yeah, we'll do it by groups, okay? We'll do
the
first
thing
and go there. Okay?
I'm sorry, I'm just...
Bols Mission Cave is on a Sunday, so I name him Senor Domingo, which means Mr. Sunday,
yes.
Okay? The second time I came in here is on a Friday with my children and my wife, you know, all my kids, you know.
Yeah.
Baby to the oldest, you know. My baby was like 2 years, 4 years old when he came in the cave, and, you know, we still remember.
Wow.
Oh, yeah, stuff like that you don't forget.
Right. Then we have, to the back there we started back again.
Mm-hmm.
Then to the back there we have ashes from the Mayans.
Mm-hmm.
So then we have some of the spinal cord or the backbone to the back there.
Mm-hmm.
Then in the middle we have some of the toes and the finger joint in the middle, okay? Then we have sockets from the upper part of the legs.
Mm-hmm.
So I see bowels around and this and that, and it seems like I make a good idea,
mm-hmm.
and I put it on top of the... The patris or whatever, so that it dry.
Yeah.
so I don't stay human.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You know, I could say I shouldn't do it, but for me, 100%, I save it. Otherwise, you see down there, it would be wet and, like, you know, it would be, like, gone already.
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah. I love this, all the bones there, the teeth and the jaw.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
It is. Well, the skull or whatever is not advised, but the teeth, you can hold one of the teeth for sure. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And also, we have a baby teeth here. Mm-hmm. See a baby teeth here?
Little teeny ones.
Wow.
It's a baby teeth, but yeah. Where bones, we do not know. It's all been rotten, maybe. Yeah. And some of the teeth have been filed.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. In
filed.
Filed, yeah. Up. Yeah. And the mice file teeth and like put jade teeth or obsidian on the teeth right in the front.
Mm-hmm.
So that when you smile.
Yeah, so it's pretty.
You want to hold the teeth, is
it? What? I don't want to damage it with with my sweat.
Oh, yeah.
No, I'm so
adrenaline pushed right now. This is just amazing for me.
It is.
This would be like, for me, this is the first time I've been in the cave, so this is like when you discovered it.
Mm-hmm.
Right, okay. Oh, yes.
Yeah.
When I discovered to God, I mean, I didn't cry, but I feel the power.
Oh, you will. You do feel the power.
Oh, wow. That's amazing.
What's the little turkey drying there on it? The turkey, yeah. Then the Maya brewing the food. And this piece has also Maya calendar on the edging, okay?
Oh, yeah. Oh, okay.
Yeah. And all this should be in like that. Yeah. More, no need. But I cut it that way. Oh, can do that. Huh? Look at this one, no drawing there. Maybe another one. See? More Maya calendar pieces, okay?
Incredible.
It is. You can see it's not smooth, it's rough. Feel it. Yeah. Yeah, you can feel it, it's nothing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. You know?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And it's heavy.
Yeah, it really is. Well, you know, you gotta crush that mice.
Yeah. Then, here. This is the fine carbon, but it is smooth, like
that's
glass.
That's more quartz, yeah.
Right. And
oh, shiny, look at that.
Yeah.
They don't have this in like anywhere in the museum. So the archaeologist may want to draw that and carry it to a certain room. It can go out from here. I'm the owner, you know.
So what's down the hole there?
Okay, I'll finish.
I saw that hole there and I'm going, okay.
I got a chamber tree. It has 1,000 broken pieces of butter in there. And but low in water jar. So you send people my way, I'm happy.
Oh, we will send people to you, my friend.
Thank you, brother.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, got it. Yeah. No, I can take care of your mug. Yeah. Oh. No,
watch out this part of this thing here.
Yeah, I see.